So the speakers of this session will explore various technologies, sometimes on the edges of what is possible now. And the first one is someone who comes from my hometown. I'm very happy about this. He is programming in something called Erlang. If you haven't heard about this, then you are very much excused, and you will tonight. Please welcome Michał Ślaski.
Hi. Hello. My talk will be a bit more technical. Today, I want to tell you why I think we, the programmers, need to change the way we program computers. It's because of the growth of the amount of digital information. In 2011, 1.8 zettabytes of data will be generated. Probably most of you don't even know how many zeros a zettabyte has. And it's constantly growing. And we need more computer power to digest it, to crunch all the bytes. And this is one of the reasons, one of the challenges that we need to face. The problem is that since around 2005, processors don't get any faster. You can see this flattened line around 2005. Computers don't speed up anymore. Instead, they get more cores. A multi-core processor is like having more processors, but it's just in one unit. In 2 years' time, processors will have 32 cores. Okay, good news. So what's the problem? Try to imagine that those 32 cores are like 32 chickens running around. Did you ever try to orchestrate 32 chickens running around and try to make them do what you want them to do? No? I'm not surprised. It's very hard. And those are the reasons why we, the programmers, need to change the way we program computers. I will give you some examples of what kind of changes to expect. Most programmers used so-called imperative programming languages, where equation like this one is perfectly fine. It actually makes a mathematician cry, but programmers are just fine. They will need to change and start to use functional programming languages, where the equation would look like this. Now mathematicians are happy and programmers cry, because this is not the way they've been doing this over the decades. I will give you another example. What if two chickens would like to eat one apple, the same apple? If you would ask a programmer to solve this problem, he would say, well, let's share an apple. But what if you have 32 chickens? It would be just like a chicken fight. So instead of sharing the same information, we will clone the information. We will copy it, pass it to the chicken, to the other chicken, and then everybody is happy. This is how applications will look like. We will have thousands or hundreds of thousands of parallel activities sharing information by cloning, by copying. This will scale, meaning you can need more power, you can get more power as long as your application is designed this way. And one more example. In the past, if you had a network of computers, you would program them separately. One computer, one operating system. Three computers, three operating systems. What is going to change is that those will be seen as one super system. Programmers will no longer need to worry about making sure that it all works together. They can focus on developing the applications itself. And the applications of today and of tomorrow will look like this. Running on those supercomputers, we sometimes call them clouds as well, and passing apples, bananas, and plums, whatnot, around by copying and by cloning. We are facing a new paradigm shift. If you would be attending the GoTo conference in Copenhagen this year and listen to the keynote speaker named Kresten, he said, the multi-core revolution comes. You will be better prepared if you know Erlang. So what is Erlang? Erlang is a programming language. It's basically has features which address all the issues I just raised. It is open source, meaning that you can download it for free, try it out. This is what I did 7 years ago when I fell in love with it. And with Erlang, there are already applications being created. Those are some frameworks for computing, some big databases. Think of thousands of devices that need to upload data to the main server. This is what can be done with Erlang. Some others will talk about other technologies. I could talk about Erlang for quite some time. I'll better stop. The point I want to make is that the software world is facing a paradigm shift. And if you are a programmer, you may want to prepare yourself. Thank you.